Hey, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're going to be doing something a little bit different here. If you've been using HighLevel for a while, you understand there's certain areas of HighLevel that you can customize and some that you can't, at least not out of the box. So one of the biggest things that I get from people that use HighLevel is, how do we get this thing to look custom, to look more like what our maybe our logo colors are, so that they're not just plain Jane, white, out of the box type look and feel. So in this video, I want to sit back and show you how we're going to get that done and how you can do it at a zero cost. Great. Before we continue, if you could just hit the subscribe button on this channel, I would appreciate it. If you do like the video, give me a thumbs up and like it. It really does help me out. Let's go ahead and hop into it. Awesome. Okay, so here we are inside of a HighLevel dashboard screen. Now, inside of HighLevel, this is actually a sub-account level. We're just using an example of one of the sub-accounts that I have. And I want to show you this dashboard that you get in a sub-account really is one of those areas of HighLevel that you can't, there's no customization on this screen. There's no way for you to go in and edit particular things and adjust, change colors. So you need a tool to be able to do that. So I found a really great tool that's out there. It's free. You can download it. It's a Chrome extension. So I use Chrome. If you don't, I'm sorry. This video is only for a Chrome extension. I don't know if it exists in any other browser, but in the Chrome extensions, if you go to the Chrome Web Store, what you want to search for is Visual CSS Editor. So, and if I could spell visual right, but Visual CSS Editor, this is what you want to do. You want to click on this. Notice over here on the little bar, I've already added it, so forgive me, I've saved a step. But you're going to click on this, add this extension, and then probably want to be your best bet is to pin it to your toolbar to make sure that it's always available. If you take a look at it here, I thought I could do it. This little icon right here, this sort of like little orange with three dots in it, this is what the icon looks like. So now that we've got that loaded, let's hop back over into HighLevel and show how we can customize this. So again, this screen doesn't have any customization. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to load the Visual CSS Editor. So I'm going to click on this, give it a second to sit back and load. And you're going to see what we get is we're going to get some toolbars here. Now, this video is going to go over some basic customizations. You can spend hours and days going over this tool, customizing every little bit of it. But I wanted to just introduce you to the tool in this video. I want to show you just some of the things that you can do and then how you would actually apply those customizations inside of HighLevel. That's the goal of this video, not to do an in-depth 3-hour customization of how to do everything on this one here. I'll let you guys figure that out. You can play with the tool later and once you understand the basics and fundamentals. So let's hop into it. Notice on the screen here, as we hover over different areas, different areas get populated. So right now, if you're looking to highlight something, what I'm looking to do on this one is just to make the title bars look better. Now, if you notice my particular logo, the colors that I'm using are like a purple and an orange color for logos. So what I'm going to do is try to customize it a little bit better so that the colors match. So I'm going to click on this card header. And what you're going to see is now you get a card header option over here on the right-hand side. So I'm just going to go to background, click on the color, and I'm just going to choose this default orange color. Okay? Now, that changed the color of one section of the screen. So what I'm going to do is just simply come over here and notice I have to kind of click on it again to sit back and get the color change. But I'm just going to go through and quickly change the color on all of these to be the same. So forgive me, I know this is going to be a little bit repetitive, but so we got this one up. We need to click it again here to get the background color, choose a default color, come to the background. So I'm not going to bore you with just simply doing everything, but I just wanted to show you right now here in just a matter of seconds, I quickly just changed the color on the toolbar headers just to make it more colorful, more interactive. When you actually are in this software using it every day, it's helpful to be, you know, visually stimulated. So right now I've got all of these items here that have already been selected. Oh, and I'll just make a quick change to this one too here. Might as well be thorough. So here we've got all the colors changed. Now, the question is great. Now, before I continue, I want to make sure you understand the color changes on this screen are not permanent. You can play, you can adjust, you can do whatever. What you do on this screen does not affect your high level in whatsoever. So what I'm going to show you now is how do you take the changes that you've made on this screen and now apply them so that they are permanent. And not necessarily permanent in the sense of, you know, you're going to make a change and you can always go in and edit that code or erase it, delete it, or remove it later. So once you have the areas that you've selected all done and configured, you want to click on this nice little export feature. So here you're going to get a whole bunch of CSS code. I'm not going to go over the CSS code, but I'm just going to come here and highlight all, and I'm just going to copy it. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to sit back and just go into, I want to leave that screen open in case I want to make any changes, but I'm going to open up a secondary screen here, and I'm going to go back into the same sub-account that we were just in. Now, once you're in the sub-account, notice that the changes that you saw on the other screen have not been made yet. So here's the changes that you made that are temporary, that is sort of a mock-up, if you will. And here are the changes permanently. So what we're going to do is we're going to make sure that these changes that we make can actually be included. So I'm going to go to the settings, and then I'm going to go to the business profile. So, not the business profile. When you go to your inside of this, you have to go into your agency level. So sorry about that. You have to go into your agency level and click on your company area. Once you go into your company area, you can come down here, and this little box right here is where you change your CSS code. Okay. Now, if you have, if you just want to click here, you'll just see custom CSS to run in the agency account. So you notice I already have some items in here. I don't want to change those. I just simply want to add to the existing customization. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to scroll down all the way to the bottom, click in this little bottom area, and just simply paste the code. Now, once it's pasted, I'm just going to simply update company. Now it's going to be updated. So now that the CSS code is there, what we want to do is simply click here, go back into our sub account. Now, one of the things you'll notice here is that the changes have not been shown yet. This is a caching issue with your browser. So if you come back to the page and you don't see the changes, you might have to simply click on the refresh button to have it go back out to the site and pull sort of the new fresh code in. And when you refresh the page, now you'll see that you have all of these customization changes made everywhere. Now, here's the thing I want to point out about this. The changes that you made here will show on all sub-accounts. There's no way to limit it on only the one sub-account or not. So any sub-account that you go into will have the same header changes in their system as well. So that's something to keep in mind. So this right here is just sort of a very simple way that you can go in and edit an area of high level that doesn't include customizations to be able to make changes that make it a little bit more visually stimulating. Now, you can use this tool to go in and customize web pages, funnels, websites, forms. I mean, you can use the same tool to do all of it, but let me just show you an example of that. Just show you, you know, why you really don't want to do that. So right now I've actually got a testing funnel here that I've been just playing with. And it's nothing extravagant. Right now I'm just going to load the preview of it. It just has a header and a little form to it. That's it. So right now, if I wanted to, I can click on the visual editor. Okay. So when the visual editor, notice I get these as well. So I can come here to the heading and click on it and come to background image and just choose a color if I wanted to. Just make it blue for lack of a better one. And come down here to this area and just choose this. And let's just say background, we want to make this color just some kind of a red. Okay, just very simple basic changes. So what we're going to do is click on export. We're going to simply copy the code that we have here, and we can come back into our site and edit the page, edit that funnel page. Now each funnel and web pages have the same features, the same setup, the same builder. So what works on this funnel page will also work on a website page. So what you're going to do is up here, you're going to click on settings and then choose custom CSS. So here you just simply paste your custom CSS, click yes, save. You just want to save it. Skip beyond that. Now, if we come back in here, we can just simply, let's not load this page. We'll close that one out and just do another preview. So notice when we do a preview, great. The background colors worked, everything worked. Now, my question is this. I don't like using the CSS, the Visual CSS Editor tool for these, because this area, HighLevel, already gives you a great tool to do this exact same thing without having to do CSS. So in this, if you want to take a look at this, I have another video on the website, the YouTube channel for websites and funnels that kind of goes over all the builders. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in here and take off this custom CSS, because I personally don't think it's necessary to come in here and to do that unless you're doing something super specific. So right now, what I want to do is come in here to this one. Notice on the editor, I can come down here and change any of the background colors that I want. So here, if I want to change the color options, and for this, I can change colors for whatever I want. That's all done within the editor. So you don't need to do background colors and things like that with the Visual CSS editor, because HighLevel in this setup already gives you the tools to do that. So you can also go into the form builder. I'm just going to leave. I'm not going to save this. But you can go into the form builder and do the exact same thing. But again, there's no reason to. So this is a great tool to edit sort of the dashboard. You can do it at the sub-account level. And you can even go to the agency view and customize that dashboard as you want as well. Perfect. But this is a great free tool for this. And that's about it. That's all I have. I just wanted to introduce you to the tool, show you where you can customize it. It's a great free way to do it. Now, there are other, I'm not going to mention names, but there are other tools out there that you can purchase. And unfortunately, it's not a one-time purchase. Most of them have a membership fee of, a couple hundred bucks a month that they will handle all of the customizations for you. And they've got a lot more advanced tools. If you want to go check them out, just Google them, just search into HighLevel CSS Editor or something like that, and I'm sure you'll find them. But I just wanted to show you something that was free, something that's easy. If you just want to do some very quick, basic cosmetic changes, how you can do that without having to pay for it, and you can do it within easily 10 minutes. You don't have to be a coder. You don't have to be an expert to simply do what I did on this particular video. Now, if you found this video useful, please smash the like button on this video and subscribe to the channel. I appreciate it as always. Thank you very much for visiting the channel and have a great day. Hey, I want to thank you again for visiting my channel and give you one more little thing here. If you are interested in HighLevel and getting some additional HighLevel training, please see the link in the description below. I do have a free course I'm offering that covers everything related to HighLevel and gives you all the information that you need to know. Thank you so much and have a great day.